Good afternoon. I'd like to thank everyone for joining us this afternoon for our Memorial Day Parade. Just a little history on Joseph J. Minchner Square. Most of you don't know, he's one of the first fallen soldiers of World War II. What you also may not know is during the Teton death match, he fell victim to that. He never came home to join his family. At this time, we're going to pay respect to Joseph J. Minchner.
Sergeant Arms, what brings you here today?
Order the dead.
Carry on.
Detail. Cut! 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 Ready! Aim!
Thank you.
join us here at the Civil War Memorial. I'd just like to let you know, during that time, 240 Douglas residents answered the call to their nation to defend it. Of those 240, 40 of them paid the ultimate sacrifice and never returned home. At this time, I'm going to have Josh Tatro come up and read the Gettysburg Address.
The Gettysburg Address. 67 years ago, our fathers brought forth in this continent a new nation, conceived in liberty and dedicated to the preposition that all men are created equal. Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation, or any nation so conceived and dedicated, can long endure. We are met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this. But in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us the living, rather, to be dedicated here to the unfinished work, which they who fought here have thus so far nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall have not died in vain, that this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that the government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from this earth. General Logan's Memorial Day Order. The 30th day of May in 1868 is designated for the purpose of strewing with flowers or otherwise decorating the graves of comrades who died in defense of their country during the late rebellion, and whose bodies now lie in almost every city, village, and hamlet churchyard in the land. In this observance, no form of ceremony is prescribed, but folks and comrades will, in their own way, arrange such fitting services and testimonials of respect as circumstances may permit. We are organized, comrades, as our regulations tell us, for the purpose, among other things, of preserving and strengthening those kind and fraternal feelings which have bound together the soldiers, sailors, and Marines who united to suppress the late rebellion. What can aid more to assure this result than by cherishing tenderly the memory of our heroic dead who made their breasts a barricade between our country and its foe? Their soldier lives were the reveille of freedom to a race of chains, and their death a tattoo of rebellious tyranny in arms. We should guard their graves with sacred vigilance, all that the consecrated wealth and taste of the nation can add to their adornment and security. It is but a fitting tribute to the memory of her slain defenders. Let no wanton foot trod rudely on such hallowed grounds. Let pleasant paths invite the coming and going of reverent visitors and fond mourners. Let no vandalism of avarice of neglect, no ravages of time, testifying to the present or the coming generations that we have forgotten, as a people, to the cost of free and undivided republic. If other eyes grow dull and other hands slack, other hearts cold in the solemn trust, ours shall keep it well as long as the night and warmth of the life remain in us. Let us then, at the time appointed, gather around their sacred remains and garland the passionless mounds above them with the choicest flowers of springtime. Let us rise above them the dear old flag they saved from dishonor. Let us in solemn presence renew our pledges to aid and assist those whom they have left among us as sacred charges upon this nation's gratitude, the soldiers and sailors, widows and orphans. It is the purpose of the Commander-in-Chief to inaugurate this observance, with the hope it will be kept up from year to year, while a survivor of the war remains to honor the memory of his departed comrades. He earnestly desires the public press to call attention to this order and lend its friendly aid in bringing to the notice of the comrades in all parts of the country in time for simultaneous compliance therewith. Thank you.
Sergeant Arms, what brings you here today?
To honor the dead.
Carry on.
Detail. Attend. Hut. Port. Homes. Ready. A. Fire. 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 Freeze it. Homes. Thank you.
honor the dead for World War II, Vietnam War, and the Korean War. But before we proceed with that, I want to show some recognition to Gary Elliott, the high school band director, 33 years of dedicated service to the town and his band. Can everyone just give him a round of applause? At this time, I'm going to bring over Sean Flanagan, who's the essay winner for the VFW scholarship.
Good afternoon. The America that I believe in strives to live up to its founding ideal that all men are created equal and are endowed with the unalienable right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But as people are not perfect, never have been perfect. We disagree about what these ideals mean and how to achieve them. And that is the beautiful thing about America. All are free to believe what they want and can express those beliefs without fear of repression or reprisal. With that as my philosophical buttress, I present my own personal American dream. The America that I believe in is the land of opportunity that my tired, poor, and huddled ancestors left Ireland, Scotland, Italy, and Germany to experience, and still inspires countless dreamers to make the trek. The idea that people are not bound by their station, but only by their potential and capacity for hard work is uniquely American. The America that I believe in fights to safeguard the equality of constituents and their freedom to pursue happiness, regardless of race, religion, or creed. The idea that there is strength in diversity and that people should be judged on the content of their character is uniquely American. The America that I believe in trusts this diverse group of refugees to govern itself, gives them the opportunity to choose who will represent their interests, and empowers them to exact change when they see fit. The idea that the authority of the government comes from the consent of the governed was uniquely American, but proved such a good idea that now nearly 60% of the world's governments are democracies. The America that I believe in protects those who cannot protect themselves, both at home and abroad, living up to its founding ideals on a global scale. The idea that we have the ability to exact change and the responsibility to do so is uniquely American. Finally, the America that I believe in honors those who are willing to serve the cause of helping America live up to its founding ideals by fighting and dying for equality and freedom. The idea of honoring brave men and women who are willing to lay down their lives so that others may be equal and free brings all Americans together, regardless of their personal beliefs. And uniting as one, I believe, is what makes us American. Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to invite State Representative Penna up for a few words.
Good afternoon. Each and every year, I'm humbled to take part in Memorial Day parades throughout my district here in Southern Worcester County. And this Memorial Day, most of us standing here will have the opportunity to take a day off from the proverbial daily grind. Whether it's from long days at the office, long nights studying for an exam, Memorial Day means to many a lemonade or a beer, a parade down Main Street, and the opportunity to enjoy a Monday afternoon in the backyard. We must ensure, however, that it means so much more than that, lest we forget those who do not get the opportunity to enjoy the same leisure. We remember in our thoughts and prayers those who will never again have the chance because they gave the ultimate sacrifice to protect our liberty and our way of life. It is truly appropriate that we call today Memorial Day, for we must keep our fallen soldiers forever in our memory. Whether they passed last year, in 1945, in 1861, we can never allow ourselves to take the great nation of America for granted. We must remember the stories of our veterans who were lost during the brutal winters of the Ardennes or the blistering summers in Baghdad or Hanoi. We must remember those who were lost keeping a watchful eye on our troops from the airs above or those who went down with the vessels they controlled the world seas with. We must remember those who stood up and put their lives on hold, ultimately paying sacrifice so that all Americans can and will continue to live lives of peace and prosperity. As you're enjoying a cookout or the Celtics game tonight or around the golf this weekend, please take a moment to, in your personal life to remember those sacrifices of our veterans who did not make it home, so that every life that has been lost in military service will live on forever through each and every free American. Thank you very much.
Before we honor the dead, I'd just like to point out, you notice at this square, we have trees planted. They're not just here to look pretty. They're here to actually symbolize and represent the 14 souls that went off to war during World War II and never returned home. You can see in the years that some of them have gotten sick and we've had to remove them, but we've replaced them.
Sergeant Arms, what brings you here today?
To honor the dead.
Carry on.
Big ham. Out and cut.